Very good morning to all the children of class 9th D. We are going to start a new chapter of Beehive book, page 99. Everything is written for your convenience so that you can see and there is no need to talk and ask anything. Yes, when there is confusion, you will be asking, but I feel there are some students who try to disturb and distract teacher by asking stupid questions. Still, I cannot see the whole concentration is here. So, in between, I'll be speaking the name of the child. That child will stand in front of the camera in the recording so that it is a proof that that child distracted the teacher and disturbed the whole class. 5 minutes I've already given the lecture on how to be disciplined student. Yes, Beehive is the book. Chapter is Reach for the Top. Part one, Santosh Yadav. Why they have kept the name of the chapter, or you can say name of the part of first chapter, is Santosh Yadav, because it is the story of a courageous lady. By reading the name, we can think that Santosh is the name of a man. We do not know. We can consider it in that way, but it is the name of a lady who conquered Mount Everest not once but twice, two times. Fine, I have written the, by the time you were joining, I had written the value points here. So kindly note down. Part one, Santosh Yadav. So reach for the top. What do you mean by top? She has literally reached the top of Mount Everest. But in it does not mean always scaling mountain is reaching for the top. Okay, that is the literal meaning here. This is her top. Reaching for the top can be anything for anyone. It can be, suppose you have bagged first position in the class, you are reaching the top. Suppose a person has a purpose in life that I will be becoming a doctor, and that person becomes a doctor. That is the reaching for the top for that person. Clear? So it has different connotation for different person. Clear? Whatever person is having a target, suppose you have a particular target in a day. I need to finish this thing. I need to finish all my assignments today. On the Sunday, you were having so many tests and fine assignments you completed. You said, yes, I have reached the top now. I have finished my work. So every reaching for the top is different for every person. So here in this chapter, Santosh Yadav reached the top of Mount Everest twice. Fine. So we will be reading the story of a courageous lady, a brave lady. People, you know, start associating men are more physically strong than women. But there are women who have proved that they are equally or more than men, they are physically strong. Proves that nothing is impossible. So this story is will be proving us that anything is possible, because the word impossible is made up of I am possible. I am possible. Impossible says in itself that everything is possible. Face hurdles with determination. This story teaches us how we can face difficulties. Hurdles means difficulties of life. With determination. Then, Santosh conquers Mount Everest twice. That I already told you. We will be reading about that. How did she do that? Then, hard work and determination lead to success. This is the theme of the chapter itself. Hard work, determination, continuous efforts, resilience, your patience. That will be very beneficial for you. That is the theme of the chapter. So she is going to give us a lot of inspiration today. Clear? Everybody note it down. Online children, have you noted down these points? So we will be starting with the story now. Okay. Yes, Divya Ravneet has joined earlier, I guess. Patani, I don't know. She is joining again. Or have you marked her present in online children? So she is joining again. Okay, is it clear? So let's start. No noise, beta, no noise. We will be reading about Santosh Yadav's birth and her village, her background. We will be reading about her family. Brijesh, stand up. Stand up, please. And unless and until you yourself are maintaining your decorum, I'm not going to make you sit now. Upbringing of Santosh Yadav, we will read after the birth, obviously, how she was raised, in what circumstance she faced as a child. Fine. then how she joined Institute of Mountaineering. Mountaineering in itself is a study. Nobody knows. There are less number of institutes who teach mountaineering, but yes, it is a topic of studies only. We can go for that. Then how she started her adventure and we can say expeditions, journeys. And as a human, what sort of a lady she is, that also we will be covering up in this. Okay. So I can ask any one of you to continue. Fine, my thought is already sore, so I will be starting. I can ask any one of you to continue. Think for a while and make a list of 3 to 5 persons you idolize or admire very much for their achievements. Your idols may be from any sphere of life, sports, medicine, media, or art and culture. So before starting the chapter, they have just given you task. To whom do you idolize in your life? Yes, Jatin, you tell me, whom do you idolize in your life? That first particular person you look forward to that I want to. Sports person, Lionel Messi. Okay, fine. So he follows Lionel Messi in his life. Yes, Prachi, whom do you follow? It can be anyone from your family or sports persona or anyone. Yes. Yes. Kiran Bedi, very good. So Prachi follows Kiran Bedi. Means we idolize, you know, we have an image in our mind. Okay, that person, you know, I want to be like that person. Online children, you can also better speak in that. I would like to ask you. So Riyanshika says, APJ Abdul Kalam. Any other child who want to speak or who want to answer in the chat box, you can write. Clear? So there are people whom we idolize in our life. They can be people from our life. They can be any other sports personalities or any other famous personalities. Sit down. Now any other child, I guess, will be the turn to stand up. So that is your choice. Fine. Now the only woman in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice was born in a society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing. Yes, I'm right. She was born in a society where the birth of her daughter was not at all celebrated. These days, there is no difference. You might have seen people are celebrating the daughter's birth also, as well as boy's birth also. Now the society has, you know, properly, they have, waking up from that bad dream or slumber and getting that, yes, we all are equals. She was born in the girl who scaled Mount Everest twice. She was born in a society where the birth of a girl was not considered good. So you can very well imagine how she was raised. Yes, you're talking. And a daughter, though not considered a curse, was not generally welcome. So she was born in a society where daughter's birth was not that considered in a good way. It was not a curse, obviously. But when a son used to take birth, they were so happy. They used to celebrate. But when a daughter was born, it was not generally welcome. Openly, they never used to say, but they never liked the birth because they considered boys will be earning for the family. They are the, base of family. They will take the family further. Such kind of notions people were having. When her mother was expecting Santosh, so they are going back to the time when Santosh was not even on this earth in the physical form. She was in the womb of her mother only. A traveling holy man giving her his blessing assumed that she wanted a son. So when, you know, that pregnant lady, mother of Santosh, was standing and a holy man, you know, sadhu sons used to visit the homes and all. He came and he thought, because everybody liked the birth of son, so he thought, okay, haan. He was giving a blessing, ki, okay, beta hoega, in that way. He gave blessing to the mother of Santosh. Okay, you will be blessed with a son. But to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, told him that they did not want a son. How amazing it is. The grandmother of Santosh. Right? At that time, Santosh was in the womb of her mother only. And one person came and gave blessing to Santosh's mother. Okay, you will be blessed with a son. But the grandmother was standing nearby. She said, we don't want a son. The holy man was so surprised. Nevertheless, he gave the requested blessing एंड एज डेस्टिनी वुड हैव इट द ब्लेसिंग सीम टू वर्क. सो ग्रैंडमदर सेड कि हमने तो बोला ही नहीं आपको हमें ब्लेसिंग दो बेटा होने के लिए. सो दैट सेंट गेव द ब्लेसिंग, ओके यू विल बी ब्लेस्ड विद अ डॉटर, आई गिव यू ब्लेसिंग. And that, after that, whenever the birth of Santosh was there, a girl was born. Santosh was born the sixth child in a family with five sons. Now you know the reason why grandmother was saying this. Already five sons were there. Then after the five sons, now they wanted a girl. They were directly waiting to have a daughter. So after five sons, a sister of five brothers was born. She was born, underlined with her, she was born in a small village of Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. And Haryana is the place where till date people do discrimination. You might not be knowing, but yes, a lot of things are changed, but still there are some part of villages. Haryana people, they believe that, you know, boy should be a must thing in every family. Girls are still, not in all places I'm saying, but in some part of villages. So, underline the name of Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. The girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment. Clear? The meaning of Santosh is contentment, means a person who has patience or satisfaction. Can we please leave? Recording is going on, so don't move from this side. Given the space. Clear? So Santosh means contentment. Underline this. What is the meaning of the name Santosh? Santosh was not always content with her place in a traditional way of life. What was different? Yes, girls, I'm teaching here. They have gone outside for their work, not for you. Clear? So they are telling us the meaning of contentment is whatever you get, you should be contented with that, satisfied with that. But she was opposite of her name. Santosh was not having Santosh in her life. She was not contented with what she had. She was different from others. Fine. First trait of Santosh's character. She began living life on her own terms from the start, from the beginning. You know, you can see the traits of a child since childhood only. She was different. She wanted to live life on her own terms. Where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh preferred wearing shorts. That way, she was not like others. All the girls were supposed to wear traditional dress suits and all there. She preferred wearing shorts. Looking back, she says now, from the very beginning, I was quite determined that if I chose a correct and a rational path, the others around me had to change, not me. Underline this. Page number 100, second paragraph, last lines. From the very beginning, I was quite determined that. Anybody can tell me the meaning of these lines? Anybody? Beta, you read from last lines of paragraph 2 and tell me the meaning exactly. What do you think? Yes, Beta. Yes, fine. So she's saying others should learn to adjust with me. We always keep on adjusting with others. This is what we are taught. Where society is saying you should wear this. Yes, I should wear this. Society is saying you should eat that. Okay, I will eat that. So we people, most of us, we live as per the norms of society. Does not mean, I'm not saying that go wear something else and we have to be different from society then do something else. No, the thing is, she wanted to set her individuality. She wanted to prove that I am the way I am. People should also need to adjust with me. Why should always I am to adjust with everyone? So from the beginning, it was clear that if I'll be choosing the correct and rational path, others around me had to change. I will be using the fine path. Not, I won't be doing anything wrong. But others also have to adjust with me. Santosh's parents were affluent land owners. Background of Santosh now. From what sort of family she came from? Yes, Peter, are you able to understand everyone online? Are you getting it? Send me the feedback जल्दी से. Yeah. So now we are going to talk about Santosh's background, family. She belonged to a rich family, affluent landowners who could afford to send their children to the best schools, even to the country's capital, New Delhi. It was quite close by. So she lived in Haryana. Delhi was quite nearby from Haryana. They were so rich that they could afford the education of all the six children in good institution, even in Delhi. So they were not having any monetary issues. Economically strong. So, yes, beta. Affluent means rich. Fine. Worthy, rich, notable people. So, we were on. Okay, but in line with the prevailing custom in the family, Santosh had to make do with the local village school. So that was the custom of the family. Firstly, children will go to the local school in the village only. So Santosh was also sent in that local school in the village. So she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way when the right moment arrived. What was that right moment? The right moment came when she turned 16. So 15 years, she followed whatever parents said. The moment she turned 16, she thought, I should also have a say what I want to do in my life. At 16, most of the girls in her village used to get married. So that was the custom over there. Girls, whenever they became 16, they will be finding a match. They will be marrying them off and that's it, end of the life. You're not supposed to take your career further. She did not like this idea at all. Santosh was also under pressure from her parents to do the same. So she was getting pressure being a part of such society. She did not like it at all. Paragraph 4. A marriage was early as that was last thing on her mind. She was not, you know, people think that we are born to get married. No, firstly, you have to set your careers. You have individual personalities. It's not being a girl should marry a rich guy and live life accordingly, or boy should find a girl who's earning heavy. So you should, both boys and girls should be firstly economically self-dependent. After that, one should think about other things. So she was thinking that marriage is the last thing for me. Firstly, I have to take up my career. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. She wanted to receive good education. So she threatened that this is not the way. I want to study harder and let me study first. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. That's where she was different. Fine, she was a rebel. Rebel kaun hota hai? R-E-B-E-L. A person who does opposite of what you ask him or her. Usko bolo khade ho jaye, wo baithega. Usko bolo baith jaye, wo khade ho jayega. The person who does just opposite. So they were asking her to get married. She ran away from her home, get herself enrolled in one of the institutes in Delhi because she wanted to. Do you think she's right or wrong? You tell me. Right. She's right, but her way is right or wrong?
Oh.
Way of doing this thing is running from home, but she could convince others, she could have a talk with them, but she was also wrong here. Fine. So, though her way is wrong, but what she wanted to do is right. So she get herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. How smart, over smart, I must say she is, okay? So when she became a rebel by saying that I'm not going to follow the basic norms of the society, parents said, we are very smart. We are not going to pay for our education. Fine. And but she said, okay, do not pay. I will work part-time job and I will pay for my fees. And the people who are landlords coming from affluent rich families, they feel it, you know, bad. Okay, our girls will be working harder as a laborer and all. That will not sound good if anybody notices it. So they agreed to pay the fee. In that way, she managed to make her parents agree to her education. So, are you liking the character of Santosh?
Yes.
She is a strong-willed girl from the beginning itself. It does not mean that parents ko tang karna mat shuru kar dena. I'm not saying do that. parents have given their life. She did this, but because she was born in a society. We are born in a free society. We are not like that. When you will turn 16 or 18, boys, nobody is going to ask you to get married, obviously. She was born in such society. She had to become a rebel. There was no choice with her. Okay? No. Wishing always to study a bit more and with her father. Paragraph 5, beta, page 100. Wishing always to study a bit more and with her father, slowly getting used to her urge for more education. Urge means wish. Santosh passed the high school examinations and went to Jaipur. So she was greedy of education. This greed is a good greed. She wanted to learn a lot. She joined Maharani College and bought a room in Kasturba Hostel. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers Kasturba Hostel faced the Aravali. His new phase is going to start now. This is the turning point in Santosh's life. Mountaineering, how entered into her life? Clear? How mountaineering entered into her life, that we are going to read now. Till now, what we have read? Yes. Who will give me the quick points? Jaldi se kya kya padha abhi humne, stand up and tell me. Yes, tell me. Gagan? Yes, Gagan, tell. Yes, there is a girl named Santosh for online children speaking the points of Gagan. Yes. She was born in a society in Haryana which was conservative. Then? She was asked to get married at the age of 16. Did she get married?
No.
She enrolled herself in a school in Delhi. Fine, at that time it was Delhi only. Now we call it New Delhi. Then, after that she shifted to Jaipur. Where is Jaipur? Fine. So she shifted to, sit down, beta. So, pura sunna dhyan se. Yes. So, wishing always to study a bit more, she was after that Delhi school and all. She passed high school examinations. High school examinations means class 10th. Fine. High school is higher secondary, bol dete class 10th. Senior secondary is class 12th. You should know. Graduation is BA, BCom, BSc. Post graduation is MA, MSc, MCom and all. Clear? No. After 10th, yes. She joined Maharani College and bought a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers Kasturba Hostel faced the Aravali Hills. Double underline this line. Joska hostel tha, it faced the Aravali Hills. I used to watch villagers from my room going up the hill and suddenly vanishing after a while. From the window of her hostel room, that was the beginning of her career. Beta, dekho kaise uska career bana. She would see that village people, they go to the Aravali Hills and after a while they disappear. Vanish means to disappear. Where do they go? Jaate kahan pe ye saare? And one day I decided to check it out myself. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. She went over there, she checked where are they going. She found some mountaineers. Who are the mountaineers? Those who go for mountain climbing and all. Rock climbing, mountaineering. These are the professions actually. I asked if I could join them. She went there. She asked, yeah, the mountaineer you people are. Okay, can I join you? To my pleasant surprise, they answered in the affirmative. Means they said yes. Affirmative means positive. And motivated me to take to climbing. So when she met actually good people, a good group who was already in mountaineering. And then they said, okay, yes, you can join us. She was so happy to know that. Then there was no looking back for this determined young girl. So this is the beginning of her career. Arna, please stand up. What did she notice from the window of Kasturba Hostel? What did she notice on the window of Kasturba Hostel? What did she look at? Yes. What is Mountain only. What did she do exactly, beta? Tell me in detail. He will tell, he knows the answer. Yes or no? She saw a mountain and some people going and yes, disappearing. Very good. And then what did she do? She went over there. What did she ask them? She found that they are the mountaineers. She asked them that may I join? They said yes. Okay. Hello, to be here, beta. Will affirmative is positive.